been more than a highlight show. It truly is a football night tradition. In now our 40th season, we bring you the best of Minnesota high school football.
TrueStone Financial presents the KARE 11 Prep Sports Extra. Now, here's your host, Randy Shaver.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us on this special Prep Sports Extra. In just a few minutes, Dave Fritzy, the game director for the Minnesota All-Star football game, will join me. And together, we'll officially release the 88-team roster for that big game to be played Saturday, December 2nd at U.S. Bank Stadium. We'll announce every senior football player that will take part in that game, so stay tuned for that. But first, we have some state football quarterfinal games to get to, starting with our spotlight game tonight. Lakeville North, ranked number 2 in 6A against Eden Prairie, undefeated and ranked number 1. Here we go. Eagles' first possession, 4th down and a reverse. Hawken Headland looks like he's going to get in, but he's down at the 2. Second quarter, 4th down now for Lakeville. They get the ball back. Sawyer Wilkie gets the 7 yards and a big first down as he breaks some tackles. It led to a field goal. Drew Colander knocks it home from 30 yards, and the Panthers lead 3-0. 4th and 2, Dominic Hine for the touchdown. 19 yards on the TD run, 7-3 EP. Lakeville North comes back, but then a problem. A drop punt snap. Riley Grossman is down. It gives Eden Prairie great field position, and Heim would score from 3 yards out to make it 13-3 Eagles. He would also get the 2-point conversion to make it 15-3. And then in the 4th quarter, they ice it away. Jeremy Fredericks, a short TD run. The EP defense was just tough all night. 21-3, Eden Prairie wins to advance to the state semis. Eastridge and Lakeville South, what a thriller at St. Michael tonight. What a catch here. Kyle Frent from Tanner Zolnoski. Big catch by Frent down at the 1-yard line, and it would lead to a score. Lakeville's Gavin Dean, not to be outdone, to Bo Bachman on 3rd and long. Bachman keeps his balance and gets in the end zone. Cougars led 15-14. Zolnoski would come right back. Watch this pass. He almost falls down, then finds Kyle Frent open for 55 yards, and the Raptors lead by 12, 27-15. It led to a short touchdown. Eastridge started the second half by recovering an onside kick. Things were looking good, and then this happened. An interception, and it turned the entire game around. Isaac Sin with the pick for Lakeville South. It would lead to Connor Cade with a big touchdown run to cut the lead to 27-22 Eastridge. We go to the 4th quarter. South is down, 34-29. Jonas Shine takes it in. 2-point conversion, no good. They're leading 35-34. Blocked field goal to end the game. Luke Ryersey can make that from 41, but he didn't get the chance. South blocks the field goal, and South survives 35-34. So the 6A semifinals are now set for next week. Centennial will play Lakeville South and Eden Prairie in a rematch against Edina. They beat the Hornets earlier this year. Let's go to Class A. Mayor Lutheran opened the state playoffs tonight against Belgrade Bruton El Rosa. This game was played at St. Cloud Apollo High School, and Jack Lundberg takes it in from 27 yards out to give BBE the early lead with a 2-point conversion, 8-0. Then quarterback Luke Dingman. This is a 90-yard touchdown run, and Belgrade Bruton El Rosa with a big win in Class A over Mayor Lutheran. Final was 28-6. Fillmore Central taking on Springfield. Jacob Knockreiner to Carter Olson. Touchdown pass from 20 yards out. Knockreiner, by the way, 50 touchdown passes on the season. This pass set up a big touchdown as they get down inside the 5. Ashton Toll will take it in for the score. Springfield wins tonight. Final score was 22-12. Manoman Wobbin wins in Class A, 18-0 over Parker's Prairie. Belgrade, there's the final, 28-6, and Minnesota, the number one team in Class 1A, with a huge win over Bram. One game tonight in Class 3A, Albany and Dilworth Glidden Felton. Nicholas Wally scores thanks to some push, and it's 20-0 DGF. Then Casey Macheski gets the edge, takes it in for the touchdown. It's all Dilworth Glidden Felton tonight. They win to advance to the 3A semifinals. Final score was 33-6.
Hot Highlights is sponsored by TruStone Financial.
We have our final Hot Highlights winner for the season tonight, 48% of the vote, and the winner is Hill Murray's receiver, Gavin Berg. Here's the winning play one more time. Watch Berg with the great catch, gets a foot inbounds and holds on to the ball. It's our final Hot Highlights winner of the season. Our thanks to TruStone Financial for their support all season long. When we come back, we're going to reveal the 88-player roster for the Minnesota Football All-Star Game. Stay with us.
I'm Antonio Menard, defensive end from Lakeville North High School, and you're watching Prep Sports Extra.
Hot Highlights is sponsored by TruStone Financial.
A good neighbor would give you a cup of sugar if you asked. At TruStone Financial, we don't have any sugar, but we will give you up to $350 when you switch to a TruStone checking account. It's true, because we're TruStone.
Get ready every day with KARE 11 Sunrise.
Rise and shine, everyone.
Giving you an accurate forecast.
We're tracking showers moving in that could slow you down.
Breaking news from overnight.
Yeah, let's get right to the new video.
And you're noticing.
So good to meet you.
I cannot wake up without turning y'all on.
All together, you guys are kind of like a little family.
You guys are a breath of fresh air in the morning to start the day.
And that's my little routine, so think of or making it better.
Every day starts with Sunrise on KARE 11. Be a part of the Tackle Cancer campaign with the Minnesota Football Coaches Association. Raise money for cancer research and patient aid. Look for a Tackle Cancer game in your area this fall. Tackle Cancer, sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
You do the most, so why not earn the most? With True Rate Checking from TruStone Financial, you get the most from your account. This much most, to be exact. It's true, because we're TruStone.
The KARE 11 Prep Sports Extra, sponsored by TruStone Financial.
Up on Prep Sports Extra, and I know that our kids talk about it, our community talks about it. I think that it spotlights the greatness of Minnesota high school football to the rest of the state.
Welcome back to the Prep Sports Extra. You know who that guy is.
Yeah,
this
sure
is
do.
This is Dave Fritzy, who's the director for the Minnesota Football All-Star Game. That was his son Dan, who's the head football coach at Eastridge. Dan talking about Prep Sports Extra and how people tune us in.
He grew up on it, that's for sure.
That's what he said. Yeah, that's what he said. Well, Dave is here to help me announce the 88-man roster for the North and South teams as part of the All-Star game. And we're going to just start with some basics here, Dave. When and where is this game, this All-Star game, for these
Randy,
players?
The game is on Saturday, December 2nd at 1 p.m. at U.S. Bank Stadium. For the team selection, the head coaches nominate their own players.
Yep.
Then we have two selection committees, one from the outstate and one from the metro, that select the players.
And that's how we get to the 88 players who you're going to be introduced to tonight. So let's start with the North All-Stars and the defense. Wyatt Gilmore of Rogers leads the North defense, the state's number one recruit. Going to Oklahoma, 6'4", 260, Gilmore, big-time force at defensive end. Honestly, just a great athlete. This run after catch is a perfect example. Wyatt Gilmore is going to be fun to watch in this All-Star game on December 2nd. Joining him on the defensive line, Centennial star defensive end Marcus Whiting, number 14. Little wink to the camera. Talk about a guy who can make plays behind the line of scrimmage. Whiting led the Cougars in TFLs, a relentless player, super physical. Head coach Mike Diggins told me if this guy was 6'4", he'd be a Gopher recruit. So here's the defensive ends for the North. Take Christensen from Litchfield at 6'3", 205. Bentler out of Two Harbors, 6'4", 235. Both really good players. The interior defensive line for the North, Wyatt Bell, an amazing two-way player for Rogers. Clausen is 5'10", 250. And Minerath plays both ways for Ricori at 6', 255. The all-star linebackers from the North, Mark Rendell of Forest Lake, exceptional inside backer, 6'3", 230, plays to the whistle. Many coaches said he was unblockable during the season. Great football player. Champlin Parks, Matthew Heinen, had an outstanding season for the Rebels. 6'1", 215, finished with 77 tackles, 20 for losses. He can not only plug the hole, but he can cover receivers. Just an outstanding player. Rockford's linebacker slash strong safety, Harrison Brunn, a preferred walk-on to the Gophers. Brunn, number 24 at 6'2", 205, heck of a football player, big-time hitter. Harrison will play outside linebacker in the All-Star game. The North backers, both inside and outside, an impressive list. Mason Carrier headed to the Gophers at 6'2", 225. Logan Bunker led the Elks to the state title last year in 5A. Langdon College headed to North Dakota. Braden Staples of Alex is 6'1", 190. And Evan Hatton, I've seen a lot of his video this year. Great football player out of Moundsview. The All-Star defensive backs are led by Ricori's two-way star, Will Style. Watch this interception and him taking it to the house against Orono on the last night of the regular season. He's a great athlete, 6'2", 190. He's led his team to the state 4A quarterfinals. Watch for him on December 2nd. The rest of the defensive backs on the North squad, Bryce Gapinski out of Foley, Kyle Magus of Osakis is 6'1", 180. Two Minneapolis City players, Wyatt and Rich, make the North squad. Really good players. And Hyshaw Moore, a heck of an athlete out of Fridley. So that is the North All-Star defense. Lots of talent. And Dave's going to explain here, how did we get to a North and South? How does that work?
It used to be Metro versus Outstate.
Right, for many years.
For many years. And now we take the Highway 94 from the Wisconsin border all the way through the cities and 394 and Highway 12 all the way to the Dakota border. Any school that's north of that line plays for the North, and any school south of the line plays for the South.
All right, so that's how we get the dividing line for these players. The North offense is next. We're going to start with receivers. Leading the way, Tanner Schmidt of Stillwater. Schmidt recognized as the best player in the Metro East District. Fabulous receiver, great hands, excellent route runner, a difference maker for Stillwater on offense. He's going to be fun to watch in a game like this. Coon Rapids athlete Kaijon Cummings Coleman headed to Iowa State. You want to talk about speed? Watch this run after catch on this play. Cummings Coleman, electric player, 6 foot, 185. You know, the idea here, get the ball in his hands. That's what you got to do, and then watch out. Here's the rest of the receivers. Luke Denneke, two-way player at 6'4", 195 out of Andover. Peyton Menzel out of Hermantown, over 800 yards receiving. Ryan Kangas of Winnemac. And Wyatt Osterbauer of Buffalo is going to play tight end. He's also an outstanding linebacker headed to NDSU. The quarterbacks, one Metro, one Outstate. Dalen Cummings out of Centennial and Nolan Geislinger out of Eden Valley Watkins. The running backs for the North are led by number 9. This is DeMario Davenport out of Andover, 5'8", 165. He can scoot. Super fast, great hands as a receiver, an electric player. He's led Andover into the 5A state quarterfinals. He's going to be fun to watch running behind a big offensive line. The North running backs, Andy Becker out of Kimball, a 210-pound back. Mason Delzer out of New London Spicer. And the fullback in this group is Brody O'Keefe out of Dilworth Glidden Felton at 6 foot 175. You want to talk about big guys up front? Let's start with this guy, Emerson Mandel of Irondale, a four-star recruit. He is 6'5", 305, the Wisconsin Badger commit, a monster in the trenches. He's number 72. Good luck if you're going up against this guy, because he will take it to you. Very strong, impressive player. The North offensive line is big, and they're very good. Manny Wilson's out of Wayzata. Sawyer Rumor out of Alex at 6'3", 240. Riley Peters of Pequot Lakes makes the team. One of the centers is Azri Jaeger out of Minneapolis North, a very good football player. The other center is Joe Dewar out of St. Michael Albertville at 6'3", 315. Cadman Foley out of St. Agnes, they had a great year, only one loss. And Swedberg's out of Totino Gray, 6'5", 305. Mitch Wind out of Brainerd. And Josh Dudgeon of Dilworth, Glidden, Felton. He's no small guy either. He's 6'4", 280. The kicker for the North is Becker's quarterback, Zach Bankston, who's also an outstanding special teams player. So as we come back, who's going to get the chance to be the head coach of this outstanding
group? Well, an outstanding group of players, Randy, and their head coach is Jack Negan from Robbinsdale Armstrong. He is an outstanding man who's built a great program in the last few years.
And they're in the state quarterfinals this week.
Coming up.
Taking on Andover. Yeah, so, and he'll be surrounded by a bunch of assistant coaches too, right? I mean,
yes.
Each coach.
There'll be five assistant coaches yep. with him who are some that are head coaches, some that are assistant coaches on their own staff, and they're great men who represent all over the state.
Right, very good. All right, well, we've got the North locked in. Let's check out the South when we come back. You're watching the Prep Sports Extra.
I'm Zayshawn Rich, cornerback at North High, and you're watching the Prep Sports Extra.
You do the most. So why not earn the most? With True Rate Checking from TrueStone Financial, you get the most from your account. This much most, to be exact. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
The KARE 11 Weather Warn Day signals a change coming for your weather.
Big hail, downpours, and flooding over the last few hours.
Because severe storms strike fast, the Weather Warn symbol lets you know when to be prepared.
Today's Weather Warn Day certainly has been verified by what we're seeing on the radar right now.
Think of it as an alert that keeps you and your family safe during difficult weather. So when the next storm is heading your way, you'll be prepared. Be warned before the storm with KARE 11 Weather Warn.
Be a part of the Tackle Cancer campaign with the Minnesota Football Coaches Association. Raise money for cancer research and patient aid. Look for a Tackle Cancer game in your area this fall. Tackle Cancer, sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
A good neighbor would give you a cup of sugar if you asked. At TrueStone Financial, we don't have any sugar, but we will give you up to $350 when you switch to a TrueStone checking account. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
The KARE 11 Prep Sports Extra, sponsored by TrueStone Financial.
I go on there every single Friday after the games just to see you guys talking about all the teams, and I hope every single week that we get on there.
Well, all the players tuning into the prep show as well. I hope they're watching tonight so they can check out the full roster for the Minnesota All-Star Game. Dave is back here with me. He's the director of the All-Star Football Game to be played Saturday, December 2nd at U.S. Bank Stadium. I know this has had different variations of team versus team, but what year, how many years has this been going on?
Minnesota All-Star Football Game began in the 1940s.
Wow.
It was discontinued in the 60s and began again in 1974 under the leadership of the late, great Tom Mahoney from Fairmount High School. The South leads the current series 18-10, so I think the North is going to be due for a win this year.
All right. Well, the Vikings are big supporters of this, as you can tell by the background here. What do they do for you guys for this?
You know, prior to 2016, 7 years ago, the players, coaches, and the booster club had to fund the game. In addition, we lost all of the Division I players because they had to report to their respective colleges for summer workouts.
Was in the summer, yeah.
Now with the December game, we get all of the Division I and Division II players playing in the game. The Vikings finance 100% of all the costs of the game, and one of the most important things is played at the beautiful U.S. Bank Stadium.
That's awesome. All right. Well, let's turn our attention to the South Football All-Stars, and we're going to start with the defense. Heading the South defense is this guy, Antonio Menard out of Lakeville North, 6'3", 220, heading to Air Force to play college football. Very quick in getting to the backfield, physical, can shed blockers and make the big play. Fabulous football player. Opposing coaches raved about Two Rivers defensive tackle Max Mogelson. They said he was an incredible force inside, dominant player, overpowered lineman, made all sorts of plays. Mogelson is heading to UNLV on scholarship. The rest of the defensive line for the South, Will Roth out of Lourdes. Both Mo Sain and Jade Abasiri are football recruits for the Gophers and big-time players. Shane Engel-Mueller out of Waseca, big up front, along with Easton Seuss out of Casson-Manterville. The linebackers, Landon Danner out of Rosemount, Ryan Vosper out of Shakopee will play inside backer. Caleb Jansen of Stuartville and Ashton Toll has over 100 tackles for Springfield. Outside linebackers, Joe Hager out of Lakeville South, 8 sacks on the season. Pierce Doles of Washburn is on the outside, along with Mitch Sikor of Owatonna and Dylan Banks out of Cannon Falls from Class 2A. Apple Valley's Will Washington headlines the South All-Star defensive backfield. The NDSU commit, 6'2", 195, gave up 0 touchdowns and only 2 receptions this fall. The 3-year starter with 35 tackles. He scored 10 touchdowns. Outstanding player. Edina's Owen Kemper's a rock star in the Hornets secondary. He made over 90 tackles from his safety spot. He's picked off 3 passes to date, this one against Stillwater for a long touchdown. He joins the South secondary, and they've got some very good players back there. Will Peruca, an excellent two-way player for Rosemount. Keegan Ryan out of Lake City has 5 interceptions. Jace Keeney finished with 4 picks for Fillmore Central, and Levi Pooley out of Fairmont rounds out the South defense. So, Dave, who gets the opportunity to coach this fine football team?
Oh, the South head coach, Randy, is a great young man named Nick David from Mound, Westonka. He's built another tremendous program. He's got his family locked in out there, and he's the upcoming president of the Minnesota Football Coaches Association.
And some of the assistants that will be surrounding him, I'm sure there's some very good guys and some great experience.
Every year, probably one of the most important things that I look forward to is meeting all the great coaches that are on that staff.
Yeah. All right, so that's the South defense. Let's finish up and look at the South offense. We start at quarterback. I love this guy. Bart Makinich of Mankato West is just nothing short of a special football player. Can run the ball, can throw the ball. Outstanding quarterback, a tremendous leader of their football team, 6'1", 215. He is going to be fun to watch in a game like this. Joining Makinich at the quarterback spot is Stuartville's Aiden Helder, who's thrown for 35 touchdowns and over 1,850 yards this year. The great Maxwell Woods of Chanhassen headlines the South running backs. The NDSU commit simply is one of the best football players in Minnesota. Electric, great speed, elusiveness, and tough, fun player to watch. And then you got this 1-2 punch on the ground because Savion Hart of St. Thomas Academy is having a monster year. He's rushed for 1,918 yards and 29 touchdowns for the Cadets. Speed, power, great vision, Hart has it all. Joining the South running backs, Francis O'Malley of Montevideo, and the fullback is Sawyer Wilkie out of Lakeville North. The receivers, Gopher commit, Jalen Smith of Mankato West, Quentin Cobb Butler does it all for Woodbury, and Carter Holcomb, a tremendous receiver out of Rochester Mayo. The South decided we're going to put 3 tight ends on the roster. Teddy Knapp is also a great defensive lineman out of St. Thomas Academy. Henry Novak of New Prague and DeSmet of Minneota round out the tight ends. Up front, they're not small. Hutchinson's Anton Cadillac leads the offensive line, 6'3", 305. When you line up opposite him, you're in for a battle. Great leverage, power, very smart. He'll be one to watch for the South. Eden Prairie center Will Sathers, a 3-year starter for the Eagles. That in itself is impressive considering all the great players who come through EP. Sather, number 57, 6'1", 275, just a really good football player. The South O-line, pretty darn good. Here's the 10 linemen for the South. Tornstrom will play center. The guards are Mikey Ofdahl out of Mound, Westonka, a 4-year starter. Alex Dreher is a lineman from St. Paul Central, and Jared Fisher out of Edgerton. Cadillac is joined by 4 tackles. Jack Hansen out of Egan at 6'5", 255. Luke Speedling of Minnetonka. Kyan Rauch of Northfield. And Jacob Shemek out of St. Clair round out the offensive line. The South kicker is A.J. Donovan of La Crescent. And that is the roster for the South. Pretty good looking football team all the way around. Dave, how can people who want to go to the football game, where can they find tickets? How much does it cost?
All the tickets will be sold online.
Okay.
Adults are $18, students are $8, and they can go to Vikings.com or allstarfootball.org, and they'll get all the tickets they need online.
Very good. Thanks for being here tonight.
Absolutely.
It's always a pleasure to have you. Once again, the All-Star Game is Saturday, December 2nd at U.S. Bank Stadium. It's a 1 o'clock start. We'll be right back.
You do the most. So why not earn the most? With True Rate Checking from TrueStone Financial, you get the most from your account. This much most, to be exact. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
Be a part of the Tackle Cancer campaign with the Minnesota Football Coaches Association. Raise money for cancer research and patient aid. Look for a Tackle Cancer game in your area this fall. Tackle Cancer, sponsored by Minnesota Oncology.
When difficult weather is on its way, we make it a KARE 11 Weather Worn Day. Get the latest, most accurate information as we track the storm for you, letting you know when to expect it and when you're in the clear. Be warned before the storm with KARE 11 Weather Worn.
A good neighbor would give you a cup of sugar if you asked. At TrueStone Financial, we don't have any sugar, but we will give you up to $350 when you switch to a TrueStone checking account. It's true, because we're TrueStone.
So there's more state quarterfinal football tomorrow. Chanhassen will take on Matamidi in Class 5A tomorrow. Andover against Armstrong. That's a rematch of a game played at the end of the regular season, which Andover won. Rogers will take on undefeated Alexandria tomorrow at 1 o'clock. St. Thomas Academy and Savion Hart will battle Owatonna. A couple of games in 3A of note. Minneapolis North will take on Dassel Cokato. That's a 7 o'clock start on Saturday night at Orono High School. And Annandale will play Coy Parrish, the Gopher commit, and Esco tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock. That's it for our show tonight. Thanks for watching. Our next Prep Sports Extra is the last show of the season. Friday night, November 17th. It's a special night because that's when we'll reveal the 2023 All-Metro football team. Next Friday, in our 10:15 edition on KARE, the roster for All Metro will be announced. And then at 11 o'clock next Friday, the full video version of my team will be revealed. That's when we'll show you every single player and video of each one of them. That plus football state semifinals, and it's going to be a fun night. It's our last night of the season next Friday. Thanks for watching. We appreciate it. One more week to go.